the report goes over into sort of indicate, because the implications are there would need to be a change from the constitution to allow for this, because in effect, the Families and Wellbeing Committee, the Policy and Performance Committee, which is responsible for health and community of women, effectively delegating the event of the joint committee to that joint committee, its health community of women's responsibilities. And so that needs to be reflected in the constitution, as will detail in terms of the membership. So the recommendation of the report, the recommendation was set out for members here to discuss any following discussion or questions on the proposals. The recommendations are the committee endorse the draft protocol, recommend the protocol to the council and the council in late June approval. And they also get the proposed to council that this coordinating committee delegated authority to amend and revise the protocol in the event of any changes. Once we've got it up and working, or once there is the need for it to be used, which I'll come on to in a second, then a regular kind of review of the protocol will be taken in the coordinating committee to have responsibility for any changes. It's important to point out as well, and this in the report is highlighted in the implications of the world, that the first instance where this protocol would be required would be in relation to the proposals in respect of Casbridge Cancer Centre, because the proposals in the pipeline, which public consultation is likely to be launched in June, July this year, in relation to the proposals for changing cancer services. And so this would be the first requirement for this protocol to set up a joint committee. So in terms of the timing, that gives time for the council to approve the protocol as the vehicle for establishing a joint committee. And obviously that would then be pulled through that process. So I'll hand back to Chair and
just adding lines on what Mike said, that the appendix to the suggested article 6A was the proposed changes to the council's constitution. The membership is confirmed there that not ordinarily will be through the Families and Wellbeing Policy and Performance Committee. Maybe you just want to say that unless it's otherwise determined by council, the evidence is so that there is that position. So council can appoint directly or alternatively the full position could be the Families and Wellbeing Policy and Performance Committee.
Considering so that we can the row, if you like, of selecting who is going to represent the Middlebury Council on this.
Okay, just through the chair, in response to that, we did hold a briefing with the chairs, vice chairs, party spokes of this committee and the powers of all who also wanted it, because we were concerned about making sure that members were briefed and had an opportunity to be put into this. At the time, we were working on the assumption that it might just be more than ever in terms of, but like, if you refer to page 58 of the pack, and paragraph 4.5, which indicates the protocol, the only reference the protocol makes in relation to representation is that local authorities should determine membership in line with their proportionality, and so that's the only thing in the protocol. And so we proposed for discussion really what's set out in 4.5, which would be where two members put forward from the role, that would be one member of the Conservative, and where in terms of the actual nominations, that would be responsibility of the council and the Conservative.
Yeah, just in terms of who makes the appointments, subject to that amendment, that it would be either reserved to council members or the rules of all the different positions that are set out in section, maybe in Article 6A, it would be a matter for the council or the rules of the committee. So if council didn't make those appointments, then it would have to.
Thank you. Just really very quick supplementary, just a question. I think that ambiguous about saying the protocol required that authority nominated, say who would be the
event that the families and well-being committee weren't able to do that. What we seem to be establishing, if I've understood what's been said correctly, is that there won't be two people for this authority who specifically sit on the joint scrutiny Merseyside area, that it could be two people one week and it could be two different people the next week. But they will be in a scrutiny commission.
Consultation with the Clatterbury Council Trust will be quite an interesting challenge, I think, in as much as the Clatterbury Council Trust area is bigger than Merseyside and Cheshire. And clearly we are will have to be involved in that, but it is very specific, has very specific issues for rural residents. And it's absolutely important that we maintain our own independent view, and the Health and Wellbeing Committee are actively involved and hopefully develop a dialogue with Clatterbury Council Trust independently. I know we are required to be part of it, but nevertheless we do need to make sure that we as a council put our own, in that particular case, put our own individual stance on the particular issue.
Sorry, Chair, if we're going to keep talking about Clatterbury Council Trust and the government, please declare any.
I'm just responding. Clearly, there are going to be some of these which will be of more significant interest to rural residents because of whether a service is actually located in rural or not, and there will be one. So, what this proposal is going to do is to follow through what the requirement is in not having separate scrutiny committees to look at a proposal that crosses boundaries. However, that doesn't mean that we can't review the issue at a local level in the way you're describing, so that those who do go to represent the borough in a joint scrutiny committee are well informed by the views of members across rural and are able to feel that they are representing that wide range of views.
Shares with the Master Scholarship Growth Committee, trying to anticipate any of your concerns. large amount of peer review work, documents, membership. That's why the membership issue came to a head to propose the change to come last week. But now we are in peer review, it's anticipated that we'll get changes for a period of time to allow the approvals. However, once we are through that process, there will be regular review of the protocol to ensure that it's doing what it's intended to do and working effectively.
Seem to be getting bogged down in a lot of detail about protocol, but anybody should do what I did, feel free to do what I did, which is ring up and ask and go, does this Clatterbridge, this chief executive tour, goes into the ins and outs of what they, their proposals are, and I think that's a good place to start, and I'd be more than happy to come to any committee meeting to talk and go through it, so if anybody's interested, just ring up and ask if you can go with it.
Move on to recommendations.
Yes.
At page 16. 17.1, read. 17.2. Thank you.
nearby the rural ground. I know this, the television's heading in the right direction. It's getting worse. I think that probably be a little bit of television. But we lose all the last meeting that we might sustain that. So I think it'd be the benefit of the program discussion on that. Is there any other items? Any questions?
I agree with you about not going over the debate we've already had, but I just wondered if you could clarify a sentence on page 94. It's the first sentence at the top of the page, and I've read it half a million times, and I just can't figure out what it means. It begins with the performance target is a more demanding goal. I'm sorry,
Chair. I would struggle to explain that myself. So, if I were asked for an explanation of that sentence, it's only about the opportunity. I'm sorry, I'm reading it just now.
Thank you very much, Fiona. I'm sorry.
This actually needs a different type of package which had to then be tendered for separately, put onto the Oracle system. So the tendering took longer than would normally have been with just a normal straightforward. So then what that meant, we then had to go out and canvass people. Obviously this is the one I'm responsible for. People are now paying by direct debit. So although when this report, which is in January, the later one will actually show that we now have people on direct debit, that is building up, particularly on the residential care one. So it did actually just take more time to actually get to the point where it handed over to me as the actual doer, to then go out later to people, start getting people to be canvassed. It will be a slower take up rather than say with the council tax, where we have a very large and